Hi students, this is maths video for grade 5. Again, we are going to continue the same lesson, parts and wholes. In that parts and wholes lesson, we have completed up to page number 65. Now, open your book to the page number 66. An old woman's will. An old woman's will. Once there lived an old woman. She lived with her three daughters. She was quite rich and had 19 camels. How many camels? 19 camels. One day she fell ill. The daughters called the doctor. The doctor tried his best but could not save the old woman. After her death, the daughters read what she has written in her will. What she has had written in her will. My eldest daughter will get 1/2 of my camels. My eldest daughter will get 1/2 of my camels. Next, my second daughter will get 1/4 of 1/4 of my camels. My second daughter will get 1/4 of my camels. And then my third daughter will get 1/5 of my camels. Third daughter, 1/5 of my camels. The daughters were really puzzled. How can I get half of the 19 camels? Asked the eldest daughter. Half of 19 is 9.5. But we can't cut the camel. The second daughter said, that is right, but what will we do now? Asked the third daughter. Just then, they saw their aunt coming. The daughters told her their problems. Show me the will. I have an idea. You take my camel. So, you have 20 camels. Now, can you divide them as your mother wanted? The aunt said, you want half of the camels, don't you? Take 10 camels, she said to the eldest daughter. How? See, for eldest daughter, how many shares? One, that means half of share. Next. Second daughter, one fourth. Next, third daughter, one fifth. Now, totally how many camels? Now they have 20 camels, including aunt camel. Auntie's camel. So we want to share the camels equally. First daughter shares half of 20 camels. So 1/2 into the whole numbers, that is 20. So we want to cancel 2 tens of 20. So first daughter will get 10 camels. Next, second daughter shares 1/4 of the total camel. 1/4 of the total camel is 20. So 4 fives are 20. So how many camels second daughter will get? 5 camels. Next, third daughter shares 1/5 of the total number. So 5 fours are 20. So third daughter will get 4 camels. Okay, first daughter will get 10 camels, second daughter will get 5 camels, and third daughter will get 4 camels. Now, look at here. Take your share. The aunt told to the second daughter, she took 1/4 of the camels and got how many camels? Second daughter, 5 camels. So, right here, 5. Next, you can take 1/5 of the camels. The aunt told to the third daughter. She got how many camels? 4 camels. See? 4 camels. So the daughters were very happy and counted their camels. First daughter will get 10, second daughter will get 5, and third daughter will get 4. So totally 10 plus 5, 15, 15 plus 4, 19. So their share is equally divided. Now, the remaining one is mine. The aunt said that remaining one is mine. Said the aunt and took her camel away. Said the aunt and took her camel away. See, totally her mother had only 90 camels. For the share, we can't cut the camels. So auntie got one idea. So she include her camel also. So now totally 20 camels. In the 20 camels, they divide their share. They divide their camels equally according to the share. How did this happen? Discuss. Although this calculation is not mathematically correct. Although this calculation is not mathematically correct, but they did. Next, Arun's timetable. This is Arun's timetable. Sleeping one third of the day. Sleeping one third of the day. Next, playing 1/8 of the day. Playing 1/8 of the day. And studying 1/4 of the day. Studying 1/4 of the day. Next, Arun's mother said, Arun sleeps at 10 p.m. and wakes up at 6 a.m. He plays for 7 to 8 a.m. and again from 4 to 6 p.m. Next, Arun, one day is 24 hours. Then how will I find out one third of a day? One day is 24 hours. Then how will I find out one third of the day? See, Arun's timetable. Sleeping one third of the day. The one day is equal to how many hours? 24 hours. Sleeping is one third of the day. So 1/3 into total hours, 24 hours. So 3 8s are 24. So totally how many hours sleeping? Around 8 hours. Next, playing 1/8 of the day. Playing is 1/8 of the day. 1/8 into 24. So 8 3s are 24. So 3 hours. 3 hours. Next, studying 1/4 of the day. 1/4 into 24. 4 6s are 24. So totally 6 hours. How many hours does Arun take for sleeping? For sleeping 8 hours. For studying 6 hours. For playing, how many hours? 3 hours. Next, what part of the day does he use for other activities? First, we want to calculate for sleeping, studying and playing hours. Sleeping 8 hours, studying 6 hours and playing 3 hours. 8 plus 6, 14. 14 plus 3, 17. In a day, totally how many hours? 24 hours. So 24 minus 17. 4 minus 7 is not possible. So we want to borrow here 1. Here it will become 14. 14 minus 7, 7. 1 minus 1, 0. So what part of the day does he use for other activities? 7 hours. Turn the next page. School magazine. A school decided to bring out a magazine every quarter of the year. How many magazine will they have in a year? If they want to print it at the end of the each quarter of year, which are the months for the printing? Mark the number for those months. In a year, totally how many months? 12 months. What they said? A school has decided to bring out a magazine every quarter of the year. Quarter means nothing, 1 by 4. So, 1 by 4 into totally how many months? 12 months. So, quarter of the year means 1 by 4 into 12. 4 threes are 12. For every 3 months end, they will produce the magazine. See, now third month, again 1, 2, 3. Third month 6, 7, 8, 9. Ninth month and then 12th month. Which are the months for the printing? Mark the number for those month. So for third month, 6th month, 9th month and 12th month. In these 4 days, how many in a year, how many magazine will they have? Four magazine. Three, why? Because for ending of every third month, they will produce the magazine. So totally in a year, they have 4 magazine. Next, Sleeping Beauty. Have you heard of Kumbhakarna? The brother of Ravana. Ravana is in Ramayana. One character, Ravana, and his brother is Kumbhakarna. He is famous for sleeping for a half a year. Half a year means 6 months sleeping and 6 months wake up. Most people sleeping about 8 hours in a day. Then what part of a day it is? Most of the people sleep about 8 hours in a day. That is, what part of a day it is? In a day, totally how many hours? 24 hours. 24 divided by 8. 8 threes are 24. So, then what part of a day it is? One third of the day. If you calculated 1/3 into 24 hours, you can get 8 hours. Look at here. 3 8s are 24. So, then what part of a day it is? Is it 1/3 of the day? So, what part of a year do they sleep? A person 60 years old must have slept dash years. What part of the year do they sleep? A person 60 years old must have slept how many years? We want to calculate. In a 1 day, how many part? 1/3. So, totally how many years? 60 years. So, 1/3 into 60. 3 2s are 6 and 0. So 3 20s are 60. So totally how many years they have slept? 20 years. Thank you, children. Remaining part we will see in our next class.